Stop!
I just wanted to say it to all the girls because if you are driving right now and you know, अगर थोड़ी देर बाद मैंने आपको बता दिया कौन हमारे साथ स्टूडियो में है तो ऐसा नहीं हो जाए कि आप कहीं ठुक उक जाएं. So yeah, I just want to be very safe.
Before we say anything else, ladies, this is a public service announcement. I am a lady.
Yeah, but
okay, hold on.
I see a lot of girls stammering in his presence.
I need to do this again. Ladies, this is a public service announcement. Please calm down, relax, breathe. Because Taha Shah Badusha is in the studios.
I'm very excited. I don't know. Are you serious about girls?
You just saw. Haath kangan ko aaj kya padhe likhega Farsi. Oh, by the way, because Taha is here now, and we should be only talking in Urdu, right?
हाँ सही उर्दू में बात करते
एक बार
इंसल्ट कर दी थी
मैं करता हूँ
उर्दू में गुफ्तगू करेंगे
गाइस देयर इज नो पॉज इन इट लाइक यू नो ऑनेस्टली आता हूँ कुछ और ही रहे ओके सो हियर इट हियर वी स्टार्ट एक बार देख लीजिए
दीवाना बना दीजिए
दूसरी बार देखना मन ही नहीं करेगा
आप दूसरी बार क्या हजार बार देखना पड़ेगा
सो टेल अस देन यू नो फॉर दोज ऑफ जो भी हैं जिनके डीएम्स काम कर सकते हैं What is it that they should be sending? You know, that's like, ये वाला DM I will always reply to.
Heartfelt messages. मैं हर सारे messages पढ़ता हूँ. मैंने actually खास कर मैंने अपने team को बताया है कि अगर तीन लाइनों से ज्यादा अगर मैसेज होता है तो स्क्रीनशॉट करके मुझे भेज दिया करो.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. और ऐसे ऐसे मुझे इतने
And you reply to them?
Yeah. मैं अपने टीम को बताता हूँ कि I mean, if it's just we loved your work in Hiramandi, yeah. तो वो तो ठीक है, हाँ. thank you है. पर अगर there's a heartfelt message, जैसे मुझे लंदन से मैसेज आते हैं, मुझे यहाँ से मैसेज आते हैं और फिर ऐसे मैसेज आते हैं जहाँ पर वो कहते हैं कि आपने हमारी लाइफ चेंज कर दी बिकॉज ऑफ योर इंटरव्यूज वी वॉच योर इंटरव्यूज और हमारे कुछ सपने थे हम गिव अप करने वाले थे And then after that, after watching interview, we got this energy that now we're never going to give up in life. So वैसे messages मुझे बहुत अच्छे लगते हैं क्योंकि I mean, who are we if you're not going to inspire at least one person?
That's true.
No, I want to go back to the last time when Taha and I first met.
Oh my God, how many years ago was that?
That was when he basically had this. He was fresh off this 3-movie deal with Yash Raj, and he was like, right? And I remember, you know, Taha and I talking about. He's excited for XYZ movies and he was working with Shraddha Kapoor at the time, right? And the Mutton song was a huge thing at that point. And I know, like,
I saw you when Gippy came, right?
Yeah, exactly. Now, after that, okay, like, it's been all those many years. And then Hiramandi happened. Now, take me through, like, how did you feel? How long did it take, you know, to get that call from Sanjeev Leela Bhansali's office?
I mean, besides Same. Like 12 years, 13 years.
Yeah.
Zyada nahi tha.
Not too long at all.
12 years, 13 months. Wow.
You know, so like, because a lot of people think that this is his debut and this is like the first time he's actually faced the camera, which is not true.
Not true at all. Yeah. Aise mujhe kaafi message aate hain. Congratulations on your debut.
Like, what a great debut. Like,
you know, there's 14 years of hard work behind it. Yeah. Bro. And so many movies. The struggle is actually very real, man. And actually being a Gulf kid, I know that first of all, just going over there to India.
Yeah.
Aap to Mumbai se yahan.
Yeah, main Mumbai se hoon. Main aata jata rehta hoon.
But the transition phase for somebody like that, it's it's very tiresome and sometimes overwhelming.
Yeah.
Jab aap Mumbai jaate ho kyunki the amount of energy, jaise abhi yahan pe na jo film release hoti hai, you get to see only the cream movies.
Yeah.
True.
Yash Raj, Dharma, at that point of time, UTV, Reliance, Red Chilies, right? But when you go to India, aap charo taraf dekhte ho, there's posters of different movies everywhere.
Yeah.
Right? Movies that don't release.
Ghagre Mein Dhoom Dhoom. There's actually a movie poster called Ghagre Mein Dhoom Dhoom.
Of course you would know that.
Yeah. I was like, Shardul.
Of course.
That was right outside the gym Come that you used to work out. You just didn't look properly.
I avoided those posters, Shardul. All right. Unlike you.
Okay.
No, but it's very real that you go there and you think that, you know, you're, from here, you're from the Gulf, and it'll be very easy to get accustomed or adapt to that place. It's not. वहाँ के लोग जैसे बात करते हैं, वहाँ के जो the youth, especially at that point of time, when I went there, people were getting out of college. The way they communicate, the lingo, the you know the kind of what do you call the nicknames people used to have, the way they kind of project themselves. वहाँ पे ना बहुत सारे लोग भाई भाई बोलते थे
भाई भाई
तो उस वक्त I was not used to that. वो लोग भाई भाई में सारा काम निकाल देते थे और हम लोग मैं बड़ा प्रोफेशनल सूट फूट पहन के मैं आया था वहाँ पे ऑडिशन में बोला You know, I'm like,
this okay, is like a Gulf kid problem, right? Like, we take everything for the face value.
Yes.
And they just like walk all over us.
Yeah. And you know, so like, many times.
This is trauma bonding.
Trauma bonding. You know, so many times, actually four or five times, मैंने actually पैसे दिए थे.
Okay.
To be, there was something that called glad rags.
Yeah.
And I said to be selected in glad rags, you have to pay about some, I think, 5 to 7 or 13,000 rupees.
Wow.
And then you pay that. And then they send you to a place for doing a facial. All right.
What?
So you, So that you can come back and get photos done.
Oh.
So main gaya, maine paise diye, unhone bheja. Same evening I came back, wo baithe the wahan pe. Okay, photo liye. Bola, theek hai, parso aaja, we have the competition starting, so we'll register you and everything with everybody else. Okay, ek din chala gaya, parso main aa gaya. And bro, the whole office was gone. There was nobody there.
It was a scam.
It was a big scam.
The Gladrag scam.
It was big. It was, and guys, everybody was just standing outside, wondering where the hell the office was.
Tahasha got scammed, and we have this on cam. Oh my God, I'm into poetry now.
Because Taha hai, so obviously today poetry to honi hai, na? So Bair bhi ne kal se bahut sari shayari likhi hai, okay? So ho jaye Bair bhi.
Chaliye.
Ji.
I'm very excited. Thank you.
We're waiting.
Ji. Please continue waiting for like the next 10 seconds.
Chal, main shuru karta hu.
Okay.
Bair bhi pe chhai hai aaj. हरियाली भैरवी पे छाई है आज हरियाली. How was it like to work with Sanjay Leela Bhansali?
Wow. this is I think he's getting these lines from Ghagre Mein Dum Dum.
Yeah. The only one person who watched that movie.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's
solo in the cinema.
Yeah,
but no, we want to know about Sanjay Leela Bhansali, because obviously in every interview you've been asked this question. Please tell us something that you've not said in any other interview.
I mean, there's no words I can really define him, right? Especially for any actor, will give a limb to work with him. So for me, again, who's an outsider, somebody who has always actually, ek interview tha jahan par it was in the magazine or 2012 mein wo magazine chapi thi aur wo interview mere paas tha. I read, they said, which director do you want to work with? I said, I really, really, really manifest to work with Sanjay Leela Bhansali.
Oh my God. Wow. And it happened.
Yeah, it was just that one name and it actually happened.
It did.
You know, I would never expect so, kyunki ek baar main unke piche bhaga tha. Wo actually
piche bhage the.
वो उनके वो एक इवेंट से बाहर निकले थे और हम मैं और मेरा एक दोस्त है तुषार, हम दोनों साथ में काम करते हैं, यू नो तुषार, राइट? सो ही इज लाइक Bhansali, आई एम लाइक या थैंक्स, आई एम लाइक दिस समथिंग. सो ही वेंट, ही गॉट आउट द इवेंट एंड देन ही वाज गोइंग टू हिज कार, इमीडिएटली रन आउट टू हिम एंड आई एम लाइक सर एंड देन ही लुक्ड एट मी एंड आई एम लाइक सर
एक बार देख लीजिए
इफ यू डोंट माइंड अ मीटिंग. एंड ही जस्ट लुक्ड एट मी, जस्ट नॉडेड हिज हेड, ही सैट इन हिज कार एंड लेफ्ट, राइट? But I remember that. And then I reminded him, of course, so many people must be doing this to him. I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe, right. But I remember that day very clearly I think it was outside a film fair event.
Okay.
Right. I was not really invited. I was not really invited. But,
cute.
But that's okay. But I interacted with him. I said, I have a lot of jugaad kiye.
And kis-kis-ko stop kiya.
And kis-kis-ke piche bhaage ho.
Kejo ke piche. Imtiaz sir ke piche. Raju sir, who else?
Nice.
But yeah, mostly we did a lot of jugaad to get into events.
Yeah.
Just so that, because it'd be a big gathering of them.
Yeah.
And then we would,
it's networking.
Yeah, no, it's, I mean, we try to network.
Make it sound classy.
Yeah, no, we try to network, but initially it's not that. Initially you have to, basically you get a lot of slaps on your face, right? Because nobody wants to talk to you, right? And it feels like you're kind of intruding this space. And that is the reality. Right. Until then, you start gaining more momentum in the industry. And then finally, people are actually willing to say hi. You know, because I completely understand where they stand. And so many people must be trying to come and talk to them. So what makes you different, really, until your work actually talks for itself? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So now, I mean, I went to... Which film was Diljit ki jo abhi release hui thi?
Crew?
No,
Chamkila. Yeah.
तो उसके प्रीमियर पे गया था मैं.
अमर सिंह चमकीला
तो मैं उस प्रीमियर पे गया था एंड दैट टाइम द ट्रेलर हैड रिलीज्ड एंड इम्तियाज सर वाज सो काइंड because now the work speaks.
Yeah.
Right? And last time when I went behind him, he didn't know what to say, what to think. Like, okay, okay, cool, thank you. And he left. But now he actually came and he said, he greeted me, he welcomed me inside. So, very different energy, again, because of your work, because of the amount of time that you put in. And you earned that respect.
I mean, I also feel like that's such a positive way of seeing and looking at things, because usually people would just assume that, okay, now that I'm known and now that I am like going viral and now that I'm popular, people want to be seen with me or want to speak with me. As opposed to, you know, anyone else could have said, acha, when I didn't have a Hira Mandi, you weren't really interested. But now that I have a Hira Mandi.
But there's nothing wrong with it. Like,
no, I'm saying like it's such a way.
For so many years.
Yeah, no, but it's such a nice way of actually looking at things.
Okay,
but,
yeah, no, you're absolutely right. I've actually faced that.
Yeah.
I've actually faced a person, I won't say the name, but this was my first year when I was there. Or us waqt main, matlab, to be very honest, I don't know how to speak to people. I mean, I would speak to people, but I wouldn't know how to break the ice, communicate, build a bond.
Yeah.
So many things you have to learn, right?
Yeah.
Us waqt, main ek room mein baitha tha, and there were 4 or 5 guys over there, right? And just kind of nodded at everybody, like, okay. And then, you know, you're in your own world, hoping to get this audition or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And then somebody's like, oh, this guy's son, you should go and say hi, the casting person said. I said, oh, okay, I'll go say hi. He introduced us and I'm like, hey, my name is this. And he's like, oh, now that you know that I'm this now, you want to say hi. And I'm like,
awkward.
Awkward. But that stuck with me, you know, that stuck with me. And I've made it a point to never judge a person, to never judge any other, whether it be an actor, whether it be anybody, because today they might be here. Today you might be, let's say, even a spot boy.
Yeah.
Right. But tomorrow.
Yeah.
You never know where that spot pile will become. And there's many such examples where people who were just spots or people who were just like Man Fridays have become big producers.
Yeah.
Right? There's so many examples. Right? So you never know. So that's one big lesson I've learned. That never judge somebody because where you think their supposed classes.
Yeah.
Because you never know who's going to reach where.
Yeah, that's true. All right. So I just want to ask you that, you know, after Hira Mandi, this is a humongous success, and especially for you. Kaun-kaun se log hain jinki taraf se jab aapko compliment aaya, you were not expecting that. Did Kangana call you? Because obviously she loves people who are outsiders.
Unfortunately, she didn't. I mean, of course, I really appreciate her struggle that's brought her up to where she has in whatever circumstances. But no, unfortunately, she's not the one. But like, many actors have messaged me, which I never expected that they would. And that's also very kind, because normally people always look at actors as a competition.
Yeah.
And they're not big-hearted enough to actually say, dude, you know,
yeah, really, I like to work.
Really proud of you, man. Yeah. Really like your work. Did a really good job. Now you've landed, you know, you arrived. Or like, I saw your work and it's really unparalleled. Whatever they said, right? Very difficult for many actors to say it. So that I think comes as a surprise. When producers and all say it, you understand that, okay, now we can work together. But as far as actors are concerned, there might not be any work that we have together. So that is really a big-heartedness.
True.
Right?
What about actresses?
A few of them that I've already know, I guess, have messaged me. People who are mostly outsiders and who have recently made it in the past few years, they've been very kind, especially in events. They've come up to me directly and they're like, dude, you know, we're so proud of you. Just as an example, we were at some IWM Buzz Awards and Siddharth Chaturvedi, right, who's now become like a friend. Before I just knew him, like, you know. But on stage, he comes and he's like, dude, you know, really appreciate your work and, you know, really good.
How
like,
nice.
I've got a, you know, so... big-heartedness, you know, accepting. Even he's from outside,
so,
you know, and he's accepting it. And there's so many other people like that. So really, those things really touch my heart, because brotherhood, man. Like, you know, I'm not trying to step on your shoes, bro. But be kind, bro.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Yeah,
but we are very happy about one thing, that now UAE has is, or you know, UAE ka apna poster boy hamare paas.
So, this was also one of my first conversations. We were talking about being Dubai babies or Gulf kids, or as you call it. So, for everyone else who's tuned in right now, Taha, tell us, when you were in the UAE, where did you go to school?
School. सबसे पहले तो मैं अबू धाबी में था, तो वहां पर एक इंडियन स्कूल था कॉल्ड शेरवुड एकेडमी, तो मैं वहां पर था थर्ड ग्रेड तक. उसके बाद फिर आई शिफ्टेड ऑफ टू इंडिया फॉर टू इयर्स थ्री इयर्स बोर्डिंग स्कूल में. But then I came back, I was in Shaifat. So I'm a Shaifat kid.
And we had no idea that we were neighbors.
Yeah?
Yeah, we had no idea because I was in the school right opposite Taha school.
Auron English.
I was in Auron. We were both next to the cricket stadium. And then I was asking Taha, I'm like, where would you stay if you were going to Shaifat? And you said?
Right opposite it.
Shaba. And yeah. I was like, I was in Shaba. And I'm like, where in Shaba were you staying? And he's like, you know, the British compound, the... Yeah, and I was like, I was in the British compound.
See, that's the problem with you Dubai babies. You don't ask each other for chai, shakkar, chini,
dahi.
That's why you never come to know.
No, that's why I said no. Communication nahi tha na jab Mumbai aaya to pata chala ki kya kya karna padta hai.
Bye.
Same, yahan pe hum hamare community mein hamare villa ke andar kaafi the.
Very good. You stay there, I stay here. Very happy, very happy.
Exactly. And yeah, then, I mean, when we got talking, we were talking about the whole the Dubai connection or Gulf Kid connection and the struggles. Because when you go back to India, they know that you're not from here.
Yeah, they're 100%.
They know.
How? What gives away the accent?
I guess the accent is one, of course, very obvious.
I think the naiveness.
But like once they start talking to you, once they understand, I mean, it's supposed to be definitely the accent, 100%. But besides that, I guess it's the naiveness, sure. But I also feel the way you react to things.
Yeah. Mm.
Your sense of humor also gives you.
Yeah,
humor.
Yeah.
And mostly it's sometimes, I felt very awkward at times because I was not able to.
Break the ice?
Not break the ice. I was not able to relate.
Yeah.
I was not able to relate with the things that people were saying.
Yeah, the humor is different. The conversations are different.
The conversations are different.
Yeah.
Right? It's like this, especially when I... And then when Delhi people you meet, वो तो अलग ही है.
अरे तू जानता नहीं मेरा बाप कौन है.
मैं क्यों जानू, तुझे जानना चाहिए.
Delhi people are different. Then if you meet people from Chandigarh people are different. Yeah. So, and then people always keep talking about you know, all these different Sindhis, this, and I'm like, how do you? They're like, ये तो सिंधी है. मैं बोला भाई मतलब क्या, what does he mean by this सिंधी? You know, I never understood all that. Now of course I've got PhD in that thing, so I'm good.
So now clarify, are you still staying in Dubai or you have completely shifted to Mumbai or you keep coming? Like, because a lot of people have been asking us that कहाँ तू दुबई रहता है ना.
नहीं, अगर आपको वहाँ पे काम करना है तो आप यहाँ पे नहीं रह सकते. Yeah, this is like a place where I come back maybe for a week, 10 days, meet my parents, meet my brother and everybody, meet my friends. And then mostly I come back, to be very honest, was for promotion. Initially, I went to India for 1.5 years. I didn't come back for 1.5 years. Until I shoot my first film and when it was released, then I came back. I said, brother, I won't come back until I do something.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. So, that's how it went. But right now, of course, abhi the government has all this golden visas and all that. It becomes much easier.
Did you
and
get it?
I have.
Yay!
They're very kind that way. So, wo milne ke baad abhi, I feel that there's so many other things that I'm going to do now.
Yeah.
So many other avenues have opened up for me. So I feel that I'm going to be more often, more regular too.
Are you going to become like an investor in the UAE, picking
investor?
Up a couple of villas?
Investor. gifts mil jaye, badi achhi baat hai.
Alright, he's asking for gifts. Is anybody listening?
Yeah,
maybe a villa palm.
Maybe.
Main, to be very honest, main zyada materialistic nahi hu.
Okay.
मैं काम का भूखा हूँ.
सीधे कैश
नहीं. मैं ऐसा बंदा हूँ जो नो आई एम एक्चुअली टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट द रीजन आई लेफ्ट द बिजनेस दैट आई वाज डूइंग बिकॉज मैं पैसों के पीछे नहीं भाग सकता. मतलब मुझे समझ नहीं आता है, मुझे ना हार्ट अटैक हो जाता है ऐसे. मुझे आई कांट फंक्शन दैट वे. पीपल आर रनिंग बिहाइंड मनी, दे वांट टू डू रियल एस्टेट, दे वांट टू सेल दिस बिग गेट बिग मनी. मुझे बिग मनी से कुछ नहीं लेने देना. आई हैव नो कंसर्न अबाउट दैट. आई नीड टू स्लीप हैप्पी.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. And मैंने उस वक्त ही decide कर लिया था कि any financial crisis that happened, because I lost a lot of money in financial crisis and I was really stressed out, right? मैंने कहा था कि मैं अपने आप पे मेहनत करूंगा. जो भी financial crisis आए वो मेरे अंदर के talent को तो नहीं लेकर जा सकता. मेरे पैसे लेकर जा सकते हैं, सब कुछ लेकर जा सकते
हैं. क्या बात है, तालियां. Sound effect. But you know, अभी सब लोग एक चीज जानना चाहते था, शेर और शायरी करते हुए पड़ेंगे. But obviously, I'm no Gulzar. So
you didn't have to say that.
We got that from the first year.
You guys underestimating. Okay. Shammi Kapoor कहता है Yahoo. Shammi Kapoor कहता है Yahoo. Is there a Hiramandi part 2? That's okay. मैंने बोला मैं बोलता नहीं.
Part 2 तो already launch हो चुकी है.
I have a theory.
Yes, please.
Can I share my theory?
Yeah.
Okay, my theory is that Alam Zaid is carrying Tajdar's child. And that child is going to be a boy, and that's going to look like Taha Shah.
Look like B.
Yeah, like B, Tajdar.
She watches a lot of Ekta Kapoor, so we obviously know where this thing is coming from.
Can you confirm?
But to be honest, her thing can also be derived from Rehana's.
Exactly, that's where it comes from. Yeah. Because Farida looks just like her.
Is it happening? What? So that's only Mr. Bhansali will be able to tell us at the moment.
All right.
But we are hoping that you are right in this process, in this judgment. Yes.
I think everybody is hoping for that.
I'll casually drop this video in Sanjay Leela Bhansali's DMs.
Hey, did
you think of this?
Yeah, because he's checking his DMs.
Yes, he has to literally run after him. And that's what also he said, yeah. That's the max.
By the way, ek sawal aaya hai. Riham says, is Taha a Mallu?
I'm South Indian. So I guess I'm not a Mallu, but mere papa jo hain wo Tamil Nadu se hain, mummy Karnataka se hain. So yeah, close cousins, brother.
Okay. Hi, good morning, guys. Taha, I loved your performance in Heera Mandi. I loved it, loved it, loved it. Being a UAE kid, how did you decide that this is what you wanted to do in your career?
I didn't really decide. I mean, I was like I said, the financial crisis just took out a lot for me. So I just decided at that moment of time that, and I was into modeling over here. Very few assignments. Every 5-6 months I would get one, but always made me get very excited. So is wajah se maine jab New York Film Academy ka news aaya tha ki ye yahan pe khulne wala hai, so I was always researching. And I was getting my dopamine high, like researching, feeling good, and then I would close it. Researching, feeling good, and I would close it.
Yeah.
And finally, when the world came down on me, I told my mom, and then also, maine kabhi initiative nahi liya. I was just sitting at home randomly in Sharjah.
Yeah.
Right?
Shaba. S-Town, represent.
And my mom literally came up to me and she's like, what's up? I'm like, nothing. She's like, what happened to that? You said you were going to join it. I said, no, I was just being stupid. And then she literally just kind of like grabbed me, put me in the car, drove to Abu Dhabi, registered me into that place, left me in the boarding school where all the boys were staying. And she said, I'm coming back tomorrow with your clothes and food. And that's it. Start day after tomorrow. I was in my pajamas. I had nothing. I was sleeping on a bed with on nothing. There was nothing. It was just bed with plastic.
Moms are the best.
Yeah.
Moms are the best.
We are on the topic of moms, I've seen a lot of interviews where you've spoken that, you know, it was your mom actually who is responsible for you continuing this. There was a time you wanted to give up, right?
Too many times. I mean, to be honest, I felt so bad in so many different play times that I didn't want to give up. It's just that I didn't know what else to do. You know, because I was going to all my classes. I was doing all the necessary sacrifices. I wasn't wasting time. I was diligent, disciplined. What the hell am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
You know, so
like, what else do I do?
Yeah. I'm constantly asking what else, because whatever there was, I was willing to do it.
Yeah.
Any classes you want, I was willing to do it. You wanted me to do anything, I was willing to do it. Right. So what else? And so those dark moments is when I just felt like, dude, like, what the hell? People who don't dedicate as much time. People who don't go to so many classes.
Right?
People who don't do networking. some of them even like that, you know?
Yeah.
But they're going so way ahead of me. Like, is it not about effort? Is it not about work ethic? What is it about then? You know? So all those things, I think, really bogged me down. And those moments of time is when my mom is like, you know, I know it'll happen. Right? You just have to keep working, because look, it might take some time, but God will always give the person who puts in his effort and honestly puts in his effort and who deserves it, right? There might be a lot of people, there might be a lot of exceptions that happens, but don't look at that. That is not in your control. What is in your control is your hard work, your efforts, put in every day and it will compound and one day it will happen.
And something it did.
And it did. Moms are always right. But honestly, since he's talking about dedication and discipline, like I've literally seen him in the gym, like parked there for almost like, jitne instruments or equipment, utne hi ye bhi wahan pe rehte the. And I used to like, main kabhi kabhi jata tha as a visiting faculty. And I was like, wow, this man really works hard. But now since you're reaping, you know, the fruits of your efforts and everything, I also saw an interview where he was speaking about how you're almost not cast by Karan Johar and kind of like felt bad. Now once the series is out and everybody is, you know, appreciating me, to get a chance to speak to him?
I have spoken to him. I think he was traveling. I think we'll meet again. Of course, it's all about the right opportunity. And I mean, he's the kind of person who, I mean, he's given so many people breaks, right? And I'm sure that he's already seen it or not, I don't know. But I'm just hoping that if he has, and I would love to work with him, because it's always been a dream after Gippy to actually do a film either with him or with his company. And of course, he's the most leading production houses of Asia.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So, and not only now, he's in movies and now he has Dramatics and he has Dharma 2.0. I mean, this guy, whatever he touches turns to gold, really.
Yeah.
So, no, 100%. I really hope that...
And it's just proof of the fact that Taha can make any shayari sound smoky.
All right, so now Taha, tell us that after Heera Mandi, what next? Because everybody is now interested in knowing that, when will they see Taha and where will they see Taha?
अभी तो करूंगा ही, रोमांटिक फिल्म ही करूंगा.
रोमांस ही करना है.
रोमांस ही करना है.
ओके.
आई थिंक जब आपको पता चल जाता है कि ऑडियंस आपको किस फिल्म में पसंद करती है, तो
ये मेरा जॉनर.
आई थिंक ये मेरा जॉनर.
अच्छा, तो तीन टॉप तीन लड़कियां और लेडीज फ्रॉम बॉलीवुड हु यू वांट टू रोमांस?
आलिया, कियारा, कृति.
Oh, he thought about this.
पहले से पता था.
मैं ऐसा कोई सवाल नहीं जिसने लोग पूछे नहीं है.
अच्छा, has anyone asked you how Sanjay Leela Bhansali on WhatsApp?
Sometimes he's prompt and sometimes he can take his time.
No, like I want to know, because when it comes to movie making, he's so dramatic and he's such a, like, he's so, you know, he's very particular about everything. Does he send you like messages, like paragraphs?
No, I don't think he has time for many long messages.
Is he a voice noter?
He's a very direct speaker as far as WhatsApp is concerned.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, आपको मैसेज ही मिल रहा है, वही बहुत बड़ी
बात है. Yeah, true.
संजीव भंसाली का मैसेज आया था ना, तो आपको बहुत अच्छा लगता है.
But कितने साल में आता है वो, मतलब because उनकी फिल्में भी इतने सालों में आती है, that message
लिखने में. जब वो आपको याद करते हैं, वो आपको मैसेज कर देते हैं.
अच्छा, who did you get along the most with on the sets of Heera Mandi?
Are we just considering the cast? And okay, then I think I got along with most was Sharmin.
Okay.
Because we spent so much time together. But uske unke ilawa agar main kahun to I think Farida ma'am.
Oh, she's so cute, man. She's adorable, right?
वो हमेशा जब हम set पे जाते हैं ना, हम लोग पूछते हैं कि ma'am, how are you? I'm just like a laddu, 1/2.
So cute.
अच्छा, who is the one cast member who's always late?
Man, nobody dares be late over here, to be very honest. No, man.
So is this that Sanjay Leela Bhansali bahut daat lagate hain?
Only when his standards are not matched.
Okay.
Right. I mean, wo daatte nahi hai, matlab he gets frustrated because he wants everybody to do well.
And he wants that perfect shot.
He wants that perfect shot. Yeah. So he's not angry at anybody particularly. He's angry that I'm not able to get this. You know, and if somebody messes up in the background, peeche 400 log hain, किसी की टोपी गिर गई, किसी का टोपी ऐसा हो गया, तब भी हम सबको रीशॉट करना पड़ता है, राइट? सो देन ही गेट्स रियली रियली फ्रस्ट्रेटेड ऑन दैट. ही लाइक, गो चेंज दैट गाइस.
ओके, व्हिच कास्ट मेंबर टेक्स द लॉन्गेस्ट टू गेट रेडी? दैट डोंट बी नाइस.
नो आई हैव टू से आई थिंक इट वुड बी आई थिंक लॉन्गेस्ट टू गेट रेडी.
Yeah, with those clothes, I think everybody.
Yeah, because
yeah, that's what I'm saying. But in general, I think, I mean, there was such a big female cast. Yeah. Right? So everybody takes about an hour and a half.
Oh, not too bad. I expected more.
No, but if you include their lunch, I mean, their breakfast or something, then about maybe 2 hours, 2 hours 15 minutes. But okay. They're utna time to pehle bhi aate hain na. Matlab, main literally this call me on set at 10. They, my call time is about 8:30. Main 9:30 tak pahunchta hun because I'm already ready.
Hmm.
And only had to come there, jo bhi makeup lagana hota hai, to 20 minutes ka kaam hai.
So, I mean, look at
it. First, nahi khata na. So it's all this, so I directly.
You don't eat breakfast.
No, directly, like I eat it while I'm on the move.
Oh, okay. Okay. So. Okay. There was another question that came in. Will we get to see more of this beautiful chemistry in season two? I guess they mean throwbacks or whatever.
I mean, I think there are hamesha references to hongi.
Huh.
But I think season two kuch naya lekar aayega. Jahan tak. मैंने सुना है
like I think he knows something he's not telling us something yeah. And now he's smiling also so tell us
मैं क्या कह सकता हूँ मतलब मैं दावे के साथ कुछ नहीं कह सकता मैं सिर्फ ये जानता हूँ कि संजय सर ने इसको मोइन भाई भी वो बहुत अच्छे मतलब एक अलग ही कहानी और I think it's going to be a journey jump a few years that's what I know and it's going to be something fresh
I think my theory is going to be true. That's all I'm saying.
Well,
I'm
sure.
I'm sure that, you know, people will be very, very happy. But there's this thing that I want to ask you is that you have actually become a face for a lot of people who have, you know, kept on trying aur wo log apne sapno ke saath jude rahe, lage rahe. There are a lot of people in the UAE that I know of who want to, you know, go and try their hand at this industry. Lekin thoda darte hain because obviously the kind of lifestyle that, you know, people have here, the monies and everything. What would you like to say to them? Because kahi logo ke sapne maine aise dekhe ki wo karna chahte, like there's this guy who wanted to be a musician, but it's been 10 years, he's not even gone and, you know, tried. What would you like to say to them?
What?
Man, look, you got choices in your hands. You got to throw yourself in the deep end for you to actually know whether you'll be able to swim or not. And jab main wahan pe gaya tha to I became an avid reader. Aur usme se ek kahani hai. It was about Alexander the Great. When Alexander the Great arrived on the shores of India, he turned around and he said, "Burn the boats." Right? So either we make it or we die.
Yeah.
Right. There's no turning back. There is no other option. Yeah. There is no plan B. You can't be staying here and say, "Agar wo kaam nahi karta, to fir main yahan par aake business kar lunga, construction kar lunga." No, no, no. You have to give up.
Don't have everything. A plan B.
There is no plan B. Plan A, and you move there, and that's it. Because only if you do that, will it ever work.
Okay.
So before we let you go, you know that you become the national crush, as they call
international.
It. I would say international crush. Yes, that's Taha Shah Badusha blushing right now. Taha, what's been the craziest thing a fan has done?
A fan has done?
Yeah. Or said?
I mean, Cannes mein tha. I mean, if it's done, then I feel there were just three very lovely, beautiful girls who had a tiara on their head, and I think they were crowned something very recently, and they're from Norway, a Norwegian region, and they had come there. And I was sitting with someone talking about business, and then all of a sudden, right, there were shrieks. Shrieks, and they were like at least 100 meters away, right? And they somehow recognized me, all right? And they were shouting the whole Cannes in front of the whole India Pavilion,
yeah,
right? There were like hundreds of people there, right? Yeah. And they're like, "What is happening?" And then they all three run to me, and they're making this, and they're literally running,
yeah,
you know. And I think because of them, another 200-300 people must have gotten to know who I am, and I think that, and when they reach you, they're not saying anything. They two of them started crying.
Wow.
Right? Aww. And I've never felt that before. I've never seen that before. And it was very heartwarming to see that how you can leave an impact on a person across the globe.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, wow. I mean, it's a series, you know, but like what they must have felt through it is really something that I won't even be able to fathom. I know I was a fan before. And I know that how I felt for movies and how it felt. So there's some kind of relatability. But this kind of these gestures and love is really something which is a big blessing.
So aap aise fan kiske the?
Shahrukh.
Shahrukh, yeah.
Hey. I think everybody loves
Shahrukh. You can't not like fall in love with Shahrukh.
I mean, I'm not going to shriek like a little girl.
Yeah.
But yeah. I think I've done that. I think I've done that when I was about 14, 15 years old.
You haven't like gone running behind Shahrukh Khan?
I have.
Yeah, of course. I was like.
But not in Mumbai, no, because he never came across like that. I actually was blessed to be with him in Atlantis. On the 23rd floor, he had the whole floor for Happy New Year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I was there in the apartment with him. So that was one interaction. Then I was at a couple of other parties where he was there. So it was great.
Yeah.
Right. But again, there's so many other people who also want to be around him. Right. So you're just kind of like a far admirer. Yeah. But at least now the proximity is like, where
by his more side accessible.
Right now, it's like right there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But before, the first time, where I actually got crazy was at Zee Cine Awards, right? When he was on stage, all right? And he was wearing his white suit. All of a sudden, the lights go off. And within 30 seconds, I mean, he was like a dot. He was so far away, right? Within 30 seconds, he was behind us, all right? I have no idea how he did that, all right? Where he came from, how he did.
I have a theory. He's something more than a human being, because mujhe hamesha aisa lagta hai ki Shahrukh Khan blessed hai. Acha, okay. I definitely wrote this when I saw your performances, that there was a lot of Shahrukh
from Devdas.
Yeah, I wouldn't say influence, but you know, people were reminded of Shahrukh Khan when they saw you in Heera Mandi. What did you feel when people gave you the compliments like this?
I felt awarded.
Yeah.
I mean, first award was basically Mr. Bhansali actually selecting me. Right, a nobody who didn't get it, who's not getting any jobs. He made me the lead. That's a big award. Second is that, so I mean, you can't change what the audience feel, right? They feel what they feel.
Yeah.
Right? And if they are saying it, for me, it's really the biggest. That's the biggest compliment I could ever get, because he's my idol. Right, and they could have said anybody. You know, they could have said anybody's name. Right? Why are they saying this one person's name? Right? It's definitely must have left a tremendous impact on my life to be able to generate that kind of performance, because I feel that in romance, there's nothing better than Shahrukh Khan.
Right? That's true.
If I'm literally, if they're even comparing me to his nakhun.
Yeah.
Right? I mean,
yeah,
it's
that's
a win.
An accomplishment.
It's a
yes,
win.
It is.
You know, so, man, I think that I'm so. So just when those messages are coming out and when reels started being made, bro, I was like, what?
Were you checking all of them? Were you checking each and every reel?
No, my I don't have the time to check everything, but my team definitely went, because they know how big of a fan I am of Shahrukh. So those specific reels, they are always showing me. Yeah. They're like, dude, look what came up.
Yeah.
And dude, it makes me so like, just so humbled to be in the same edit as him.
As him.
That's amazing feeling. But Taha, I have to say this, that when I saw Heera Mandi, I literally said this, that you know, there were two people I was the most impressed with. One was you and one was Sonakshi Sinha, who took away, you know, like everything. And I just am very happy that, you know, we have someone who now represents that agar aap apne sapno ke piche pade rehte hain, they can come true. So that is extremely inspiring in an age where, you know, youngsters give up on their dreams and they kind of, you know, feel extremely depressed or, you know, lost. And that's a huge thank you for doing that for a lot of youngsters.
Thank you, man.
And before we let you go, I just want to say that I was telling him off air that when I started watching Heera Mandi, I had no idea that he was in Heera Mandi. So initial jab wo scene aya, and I was like, wait, what? And then I see the whole stairway scene where he's walking towards Farida Jalal, and I'm like,
are ye to apne shaan
jaake. Is that that? Yeah, and I just want to say that I was so proud and so happy that, you know, you deserve this and you finally got this.
Yeah.
And we can't wait to see what else you're going to be doing. Let's just keep coming down to the studio, okay? Every time you're here.
No, 100%. I mean, this like you said, this is home. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, and how Shahdul Bhai just said, the more people get inspired, the more people start following their dreams.
Yeah.
And I mean, I'm like a flag bearer of anybody who needs to follow their dreams.
Especially for, you know, Gulf kids, for UAE kids.
And there's so many, and I know the craze they have over here. Yeah. I'm telling you, I was a fan first.
Yeah.
I was an audience first, right? All this is later. But I know the feeling that people have over here and how they feel for movies, how they feel for the actors. It's nothing like how people in Mumbai feel, by the way.
Yeah, that's true.
There's nothing.
That's true.
They might have great energy in Bombay, but the people who love Bollywood over here are mad.
So today when they see a Tahasha Badusha absolutely smashing it, they think that, okay, this is one of us. Yes. You know? So, yes. Which is why this feels personal, and congratulations.
It's not a win for me, man. It's a win for all of us. Yeah. It's a win for all of us who have not only dreams, but also, like I said, all the Gulf kids, I'm like the Katrina Kaif.
That's our promo line.
and he doesn't just speak Hindi, but Urdu as well.
Katrina's always been an inspiration because she's the only person who has come, like an NRI, who's come into Mumbai and actually made a mark.
Yeah.
And I was just hoping that I would be able to do that one day. I'm so glad that I've taken a step forward in that direction in the right way. And I hope.
This is going really well. Now I'm really upset with you because you said that only Katrina is there. How could you forget Nora Fateh?
No. Nora Fateh is...
Nora, I love you!
Is in a different league altogether. Right? Nora is a great artist. She's a great dancer. She's made a mark for herself. But again, she followed Katrina's footsteps. Katrina was the pioneer.
Yeah. But you didn't realize what I did there? We got both the actresses in one name. Engagement reel pe bad jayega.
Jale, you can catch the rest of this on our Instagram. Don't forget to follow us, 891 Radio 4. And of course, you can follow us both as well, Bhairavi Prakash, Shardul Pandit. And I'm sure you're already following Taha. So.
Yeah, well, in 13 days, we saw his followers going from, like, how many followers right did you do in 13 days, right?
I think within the first month it was. Yeah. It was 184,000 is who I had, what I had initially.
Wow.
And then. Now what is it at now?
He doesn't even know.
2.5,
2.6. Teen ko pata hoga, inki.
Oh,
mera phone. Yaar, dekh, baby. Teen lakh followers badh rahe honge, toh
kaise banta hoga? We can't keep track of this.
I think now his time is done. I think the whole hype is done. And it was in the hype mode, everybody is, you know, following.
2.6.
Yeah. But no, great amount of love. So many messages. Every 2 minutes, there are messages coming in. Even now, after almost 2 months, man.
And girls, so, he said that he does, read his DMs. At least the team will send him the DM. Teen line, kya? What is the keyword?
If there's anything that's like, good job on Hira Mandi, then my team will say thank you very much and this and that. And if it's a blue tick, then of course they'll let me know unless we have to do something together. Yeah. But besides that, if it's
anything,
then my team can be quite naughty.